Thank you. I feel myself, how to say, I am shying this situation because it's not so, I have very few type of this interview. And I am not sure that my case is very reasonable to say about. Nevertheless, if you're interested with this, I will try to tell you about some things which I consider as important. Well, I was born in the family of, in that time, very young parents. My mother was a great specialist in history of India. And this is what I very like to emphasize, because when I arrived to India, this is my second visit, because she, in a sense, told me when I was a child many things about country. She, in a sense, was very, how to say, very like and, in a sense, devoted her scientific life to history of India, to languages, to literature, and so on. Why? This is a very nice question, because it's difficult to explain, but in the same time, you can put to everybody such a question: why you are a mathematician? Why you like biology? This is, I mention, not only because I'm grateful to my mother, but also because she gave me the lesson, what does it mean to be scientists and to be to spend all your time without exception in your specialty. I decided to be a mathematician very early. As I remember, it was when I was in elementary school, about when I was 10 years old. I like very much to solve problems and so on. It's more or less typical for mathematicians. For me, when I look at my life, so it also has some different interests, maybe some interest to politics, to literature, to my friends, but nevertheless, the main thing is mathematics. Well, this is a more complicated question, because I can answer on this question looking on whole life, not only childhood, because my generation, in a sense, was lucky. I tell you why. Because the generation of my parents went through all this disgrace during Stalin time. Many friends of my parents was arrested during 30s and later, and so-called well-known Leningrad affair, which was just after the war, many friends was arrested. So, in a sense, the generation of my parents was, in a sense, pressed by power, and so they didn't feel themselves as completely free person, definitely. Nevertheless, they like very much Soviet power and so on. My generation was shortly intersect with the war. I was very young when the Second World War was started, but fortunately I was not in, my parents was in Leningrad during so-called blockade. Maybe you know that Leningrad was survived, surrounded by Hitler troops. It was a great, many people died because there is no foods and so on. My parents was survived, and they sent me to Siberia to this time, and then I returned back. And fortunately, my Young's also was during the more or less liberal time. I fortunately entered to university and so on. So I think that in this sense, our generation is much more happy than previous. I want to say that in the middle of 50s, when I finished university, I understood, as my friends, how many lie was in Stalin propaganda. And we didn't agree with all things which was before, and moreover, with, in a sense, with point of view, even now, on that time. We hate this time. We consider that Russia was a miserable country because the revolution, in a sense, interrupt the connection with the West for many, many decades, starting from 1917. And only now we have some chance. Is it rain? Oh! You know, I ask many people, are there rain? No, there is no rain in India. This is typically for St. Petersburg. Okay, thank you very much. I feel myself at home. Okay, so this is maybe answer on my question. Even now, I didn't agree with point of view on many people now that Stalin's time was good and communist time was good. I completely don't agree. I was very happy with my teachers. Let me tell you a few words about this. The tradition of Russian science when I was a student and graduate student in Leningrad was very good. I can mention some of my teachers. For example, it was Kantarovich, well-known mathematician and economist, Nobel winner, Фадеев, old Фадеев, algebraist, Rohlin, my main advisor, topologist and specialist in dynamical system, Fichtengold's analyst, maybe you know the textbook of analysis by Fichtengold, then Линник, well-known probabilist, Александров, geometer, great geometer of 20th century. All of them was my lecturer. I listened to the lecture, I contact with them. Фадеев gave me the first problem, I remember, function on matrices on my second course. Yes, then I had advisor, pupil of Kantarovich, Akilov, and then Rohlin became, he went to St. Petersburg in 16, and he was my main teacher in dynamical system and topology, even in functional analysis. Later, I have very tight contact with Gilfand. He lived in Moscow, but when we make contact, it was in beginning of 70s. He attracted me to his school, and I was I had many, about 10 papers with him and Graev. So, and this is why I, in a sense, one important thing, that Rohlin was a student of Moscow Mathematical School before the war. He has extremely rare biography. His father was arrested. He was a student of last course in Moscow University when the Second War started. He wanted, as how to say, he's willing to go to not regular army, but some kind of pseudo army. He was in the German camp because they were surrounded and obtained to, and then he spent several years in his in this Hitler's camp. Then he went to Stalin camp because they must so-called to check if he is spy or not. And only because Kolmogorov and Pantryagin wrote the letter to Top, and they was freed and went to Moscow, and because he was Jew, he can't find good job. He went to Provincia. Only in beginning of 60 he arrived to St. Petersburg, and last 20 years he lived in St. Petersburg. I immediately understand that he is a great scientist of the main. He was not academician. He has no any some kind of trivial approval from the top, but nevertheless he had a great authority. Many people like Arnold, you know him, Anovikov, Fuchs, Sinai, was partially the his pupils, partially simply collaborators. So I also was one of the people, and I obtained many very important things from him. For example, he tried to teach us that mathematics must be, in a sense, ideological. It's important to obtain idea. Then you can calculate, prove, and so on. But very important to have a very clean clean philosophy when you consider even concrete question. When I was a student, I like very much to learn the paper of classical of mathematics. Really, I confess you that I didn't, I hadn't read, say, Hilbert and maybe Lagrange. Yes, but I at least I tried to read some well-known papers of mathematician of 20th century, like von Neumann. When I was a student, I have read many papers by von Neumann, Hermann Weyl, of course, Russian Kolmogorov. I remember then when I was a student and decided to read all issue of main Russian mathematical journal, which called Uspekhi, Russian Mathematical Service, which started publishing in the 30s, and I decided to read as I can all first 10 or maybe more years of issues. So it was some problem to go to humanitarian or not. I like very much literature. I say can write poem, rhymes, and so it makes some interest to humanitarian things. But I, of course, I decide interrupt this. And of course, first of all, I like mathematics, but secondly, I understand that there's only one way to preserve personality. And so this is many other things. One the reason why authority of Russian mathematics was very high. Now it's not so much, but nevertheless, it was it was several explanations. One explanation is the following: many talented guys who can in other countries go to business, to say to philosophy, to politics, they have no possibility in Soviet time, because in this case you must be member of party and to listen all these stupid things, and so you have to have compromise with power, and many people didn't want to do this, and so it was very good favor for mathematics, because many people goes to mathematics and physics during say 30, 40, till the 70, Russian intelligentsia was, in a sense, isolated from Western. It was no any very few direct contact. Even in 70s, I obtained a lot of invitation when I already was mathematician. I obtained a lot of invitation to go to conference to, and of course I have no right to do this. Only few guys who has very good behavior, not me, I have very bad behavior in political sense, they can do this. So it creates some, structure when you have no contact with others. So you have to have everything here. And so in Russian mathematics was all part of all modern mathematics in that time. And so in a sense it was some kind of self-contained part of the science. Well, first of all, excuse me, I know many Indian names, but I'm not sure that all these names belongs to people who work in India, maybe sometimes in US. For example, Harishchandra. Harishchandra is, well, for me, is well known because I study representation theory after Gelfand, contact with Gelfand and before. But as I know, he was mainly in the West. And I don't know. Anyway, definitely it's, yes. And I know many other guys. For example, Grisha Margulis, my very good friend, he has very serious contact with Indian mathematician in Lie algebras and discrete subgroup of Lie algebra, Raghunathan and his school. Well, what I can say, the similarity between Indian mathematics and Russian is very natural, because both country has, in a sense, their own world, as I told about Russian. I think in India also. But the difference is the following, that Indian mathematics was very, naturally very, had very good connection with world in US and in Europe. In that time, it was not true for Russian mathematics. But what is another common property that, especially last 20 years, many people want to go to emigrate from Russia to the West. And as I understand, the same is true for Indian case. But what is important, I don't know about India, but for Russian, unfortunately, this process has no still, stable form. I agree that in the world, first of all, my opinion that there is no Indian mathematics, Russian mathematics, there are mathematics. And all country had some donation, some contribution to this. So it's not not useful to divide these things. But of course, it's natural that young guys who was born in different country, they started in this country. And this is important to have good education in this country. Later he decide either to go to not to go. It depends on the many things. So in Russia, this process was unnatural. First of all, till, say, 70s, it's impossible to emigrate at all, only in illegal way. Then, during, say, 20 years, it's possible only for special people. For example, it was Jewish emigration, which was legal, but not approved. And only after perestroika it will be more or less. And of course, a lot of good mathematicians. This is a main problem for Russian mathematics. Many schools, many seminars almost disappeared because many people don't. But in a country which has a natural way of developing, it's natural, the process in both directions. Some of them work for several years and then return back. I know this in Japan, and now in China, by the way. In Russia, it's almost very rare. People who emigrated return back. It's special. Why? Because there is no stable situation in the country. And this is very bad. I don't know about India. I think that in India you also have such a balance between two directions. And so it's. So what I want to say, returning back to your question, this is why I think that it's difficult to say what you say about India. Because it's together with some people who work in another country and so on. And also I want to say that direct contact between India and Russia is not so good. I mentioned yesterday that, for example, in all countries, in US, in each university you can find people from Russia. Either graduate student or even immigration and so on. The same in France. Even in Japan, I know several people. I don't know anybody from in India who came to, as well as I don't know in other direction. And this is only one example. But in general, I think that the connection between mathematicians must be more vivid. I know, by the way, it was some special probabilistic conference, India-Russian. The last one was recently in Delhi, and it was some years ago, but this is very rare and not so. So it's better to have more, especially because now it's possible to visit, for example, St. Petersburg. You can arrive to us, and we can take part in our seminar and so on, as I hear. Opinion about mathematics is the same as opinion about, say, art or, I don't know, nature. If you like something, for example, why you like such a picture and don't like other picture? This is a question about your taste. And my impression that in mathematics there is a hidden some, each mathematician has some taste which show you what kind of problem is pleasant for you and what kind not. It's very difficult to explain, and moreover, it's important to understand that this feeling came not immediately, not when you are 20, later. But step by step you understand what kind of problem in different kind of mathematics is similar. This is the first, my first answer, because I consider this the aesthetic taste is very important in mathematics also. Of course, when you go to, say, industry, somebody gives you the problem, you have to solve this problem. This is another situation. You must do this, of course. But nevertheless, if you choose some question among many possible, it's important to listen your internal voice. This is one thing. The second thing that, and this is also very important, I think that, and this is not my thesis, it's many people like Hilbert and many other claim that mathematics is alone, unique. And the connection between different areas can be hidden. And so I feel more and more that this is true. And if you look at my interest, which on the first glance looks as very different, maybe today lecture is one of the examples. I tell you about at least three different things, and about each of them I can give separate talk in which I never mention other two. This is can be considered as completely different. But it happened, and this is a very pleasant moment when you understand that this is connected, and not by chance, but there is indeed some intrinsic connection between this. And so I can give many examples. So this is things, and this is good, but this is also not so good, because there is another opinion that you must concentrate it and one problem, like Poincaré problem, and try to solve it, and that's all. Yeah, there is a different kind of view, but my impression that the wideness and connection between different area of mathematics is one of the important, very important things. Yes, well, I want to continue my claim that I was lucky with my teachers, and I want to say I am lucky with my students, at least most of them, definitely. Well, one of them told me that there are no two among this graduate student which has the same topic, closed topic. All of them also different. This is in a sense true. Well, I am not champion in this. I know some of my friends who have even more students, but my impression that in my case, the following is important. I didn't, how to say, never regret about a moment when I gave my lover's topic to my student. Sometimes we continue to work together, sometimes I put him and so on. So most of my good students believe me that this is a very interesting topic, and they continue. I can give you some examples. So, for example, one of the first my student, even he was not my graduate student, because he was he finished university, and I can't convince the university to accept to graduate school. But he was very talented. This is Igor Frankel. And I immediately understood the his ability and work with him. Then he emigrated and becomes very well-known, more mathematical physicist in Yale. Another example, my student in random walks, I started this topic in the middle of 70s and attract him. He was a student of third course, even a second course. And so I gave them, and now he becomes a well-known specialist, and we wrote well-known paper. His name is Kaimanovich. Also we have, I can continue. One of the main my collaborator was Kerov, which I mentioned today. Unfortunately, he died in 2000 when he was about 50. And we work with him on some my lover's topic, asymptotic representation theory. Well, I can continue this speech, but the relation between advisor and his pupil is not so simple sometimes, of course. But it's very important to forgive all these difficulties and to give them possibility to walk and so on. So my answer is the following. Don't afraid to give your lovest idea to your pupil, and they will successful and in a sense will be grateful to you. Well, I have a very serious problem just in 70s when in Russia was pressure on all. I don't know if it makes sense to tell about in details. It was time when I was very close to dissident, to some political, my friends who works in, and it was known to KGB and to all this stuff. And of course they didn't approve. I was already assistant professor, associated professor. and they claim that I will not obtain full professorship because I must be a legal person to listen lecture about Marxism-Leninism, and I refused to do this. And it was time, short time, when they even say, okay, you will not have graduate student. And one graduate student who wanted to be, to go to me, they told them, either you choose another advisor, or you go out and will not be a graduate student. Unfortunately, he chose another, for several years he chose, then he returned back when situation changed. And it was a very difficult time because, in a sense, it was natural that they will at least completely ask me to go out. It's possible. Because they, in political sense, was, of course, it's related only to political property, political question, not about science, of course. Then this is the reason they didn't want to say something bad about my scientific activity, and this is why they afraid to say, okay, please go out from university. So it was big end of 70s, and it's continue maybe several end of 70s. Till more or less till perestroika, and then it becomes more immediately. For example, I tell you one thing which you must understand, I am Jew. And so the Russian political in that time, anti-Semitism, also have some condition on number of Jew in university and so on. So it's change drastically in end of 80s, and I obtained invitation. First of all, I obtained full professorship. Then I obtained invitation to academy. So what is important, not to have compromise with yourself. Wait, you will have moment when you will be right. Well, why mathematics? You can ask everybody. Well, my best time for thinking, by the way, indeed, early in the morning and late in the evening. During the day, I can write, I can speak, and so this is my answer. But of course, it depends on times. That's a very important to. It's unexpected. Usually, when you have good idea, it's unexpected. Let me say about some things which, by the way, close to one moment of my lecture. I was 1.5 months ago again in France, and I visited even with my wife many years ago Paris. I have a lot of friends and colleagues, and we live in some place in Paris, in Latin Square, maybe you know, and I have some, even now, I have some problem which still wait for solution. And I sit down near the house when I live, and some idea came to me. And this idea about Pascal triangle, an idea came on the Rue Pascal. I live on Rue Pascal that time and many years ago, and this is miracle. And the main idea came on Rue Pascal. Well, this is only a joke, but nevertheless, it's usually. But of course, the hidden things that this idea was. How to say, prepared by some thinking about this in before and maybe in a completely different way and so on. But the time, how to say, time of truth can be concretized unexpectedly in some you know, Poincaré also wrote about this. Well, this is a complicated question. I can't say that I am a very good psychologist, in the sense that if I like, if you will bring me some young guy, and I can't say, okay, he will be a great mathematician or great artist. It's difficult. I can say only that it's important to understand that mathematics is very different. Some guy is very good for calculation. You can put him some problem to calculate. He didn't afraid calculations here, but he not so good if you give him some problem in which he must compare one things and another thing. So, and this is very good because mathematics, in a sense, area for intellectual of very different type. Calculation, philosopher, say people who can compare something, different kind of things, and so on. And so if you look at the young guy, you also must understand, maybe it's very bad in calculation, but he's very good listener of the new things. This is I try to guess. Sometimes it's possible, sometimes it's not, but my impression that I have not so big mistakes. Sometimes I guess that right. Well, just now I have several, not so much, very talented guys. I hope that some of them will come to you, and they successful in the studying. The problem is to give possibility to work in mathematics. It's not so trivial problem. Thank you very much.